Hi, welcome to episode 6 of the Brittany and Brandon Show. Vanna, white that.
Join us on this podcast as we chat real life from marriage to parenthood and everything in between. I'm biased, but I think we're kind of funny. We've got a pretty solid track record of keeping kids alive, and after over 16 years together, we've learned a thing or two about relationships. Throughout this series, we share funny parenthood and marriage moments, relationship and childhood stories, fun facts, and more. From time to time, we even convince one another to try gross 3-ingredient recipes we create from everyday foods. Why do we do all of this? Because we hope that by sharing our lives with you, we can offer you the opportunity to connect with some everyday people who are just as deep in the figuring this life out stage as all of you listening. The bottom line is, we are real. We struggle to balance it all, just like you. We don't have everything figured out. But we try to make every day matter and learn from our mistakes to make every tomorrow better than the day before. Let's do this together.
Vanna White was from Wheel of Fortune.
But didn't she
Yes, but I don't think she's still on Wheel of Fortune.
That's fine.
So people may not get the reference. Not that, I mean, I don't think Wheel of Fortune's that popular with people our age anyway. I'm gonna look. Vanna White was replaced by Pat Sajak's daughter.
Who's that?
Pat Sajak was the host.
Oh. When?
March 20th of 2023. It was that...
Oh, really recently?
She's 66 years old.
Wow.
I don't know.
Way this to go, Vanna.
Anyway.
Okay.
I was also looking up that horseshoe crab blood is blue.
I think I knew that.
And it's very sterile. It's used to sterilize things.
Horseshoe crab blood?
Yeah.
Huh.
Anyway.
We have a very fun episode of the Brittany and Brandon Show planned for you this evening. The very first thing we're going to start off with is a new segment that Brandon and I are trying out. We have each concocted a 3-ingredient recipe for each other. Now, these are 3 everyday ingredients. The goal is that it is disgusting, and those are pretty much the rules. Disgusting, everyday ingredients, 3 of them, in a little container, mix them up real good. And then we are going to take some spoons, we are going to put a nice hearty amount on our spoon, and we're going to eat it.
Eyes need to be closed.
Oh!
Eyes need to be closed and fed to the other person.
No! This is getting worse by the minute. This was Brandon's idea. I do think it's fun and adventurous. But it also, you know, it's gross. So I have my water handy for this adventure. So that is how we are going to kick off tonight's episode.
I also have my water handy.
No, you need to get your own water. Anyway, that is how we are going to kick off tonight's episode. Some of the other things that we have planned this evening include some fun facts related to events in history that never actually happened, as well as some Golden Girl facts, because we all love Golden Girls.
Events in history that never happened.
Yes, events in history that never actually happened, but people believe that they did.
Water.
Brandon has departed to get water. Hopefully I've remembered to clip out the section where he got up in his undergarments.
My underoos.
So in tonight's episode, the gross food is to start. We have some fun facts that I just shared with you. We're also going to share a funny marriage moment and possibly a quote of the day if we get to it, as well as our master suite chatting a little bit about that whole situation, because we have discussed it briefly in several episodes, and we also have a series here on our channel called House to Home, and our master suite has been the star of that series thus far, so we're gonna do a little bit of explaining of the backstory of that whole situation. So those are our plans this evening, but as I mentioned, we are going to kick off with the nastiness, which is probably not smart, because then that flavor, which is likely to be disgusting, is going to be...
It's gross.
It's gross. It's going to be in our mouths. So we are going to consume this nastiness, and then we are going to guess what is in it. All right, Brandon, his cup is hiding behind my iPad. Don't look at mine. I won't look at yours. We have them. Brandon, close your eyes for a minute. We have them in these little child medicine cups. Okay. So you...
Who's going first?
We're going to go at the same time. No, that's not fine.
That's, we're both going to have our eyes closed and trying to...
I want to go first because I want to... I'm going to go first because I want to get it over with. So, okay. I'm going to... I'm
close
gonna close
eyes.
My eyes. He's gonna. Oh. I feel nervous.
You should.
Oh, Brandon. I don't think I wanna do this. Why? Why did I say this would be fun? Why did I say this was a good idea? How much mixing do you need to do? Let's just get this over with.
Alright. It's not much.
Gah. God, that was coffee ground, garlic, and I don't know, oil?
Lemonade.
Lemonade? Oh my God! Coffee grounds, garlic, and lemonade. Ugh, Brandon. I think I was a lot nicer to you.
Well, I even made sure. I said... Are we going for gross?
I don't like coffee. I don't drink coffee. I don't like coffee.
You like garlic and lemonade, though.
Yeah, together, mixed with coffee, for sure.
It was only, like, that much, too. It wasn't even, like... It wasn't even a spoonful.
That was gross, and I could... I tasted the garlic first... And then I very quickly...
I can smell it.
And then I very quickly was able to piece together the coffee grounds. I would have never gotten the lemonade. I didn't taste any of the lemonade with the coffee grounds and the garlic. I was overpowering it. It's safe to eat coffee grounds?
Sure.
Ugh. Okay. I need one more drink. That was a lot.
It smells gross.
It does. Back it up. I'm going to come and show you these cups of substances after. Close your eyes.
That's all I can smell. Ugh. It's gross. Imagine eating that. Ugh.
Yeah, imagine eating that. Who would do such a thing?
I don't know.
Okay. Are your eyes closed?
My eyes are covered.
I think that I added... I'm not going to say that yet.
What?
Just nothing.
Is it only three ingredients?
It is. You can uncover your eyes. Do you need some more?
Barbecue sauce, pesto. Yeah, I don't know what the third one is.
Barbecue sauce, pesto, and a pre-soaked in milk Oreo.
Yeah. Yeah, I couldn't taste it.
I don't think that was as bad as...
No, definitely not.
Because I think I added too much barbecue sauce.
Yeah, that's the...
That's really like, that's all you can smell, so.
I mean, it was not pleasant, but it wasn't.
Brandon won. The texture of that was terrible. The taste of that was terrible. We are going to do this again in a future Brittany and Brandon episode, and I am going to come back with a vengeance. I'm going to do it.
Isn't it just with vengeance? It's not
up. I don't know. I'm going to come back with a vengeance or with vengeance, whatever.
So, like, the pesto and barbecue sauce together really... I mean, it's not, like, an awful combination.
I should have put yogurt in it.
Oh, barbecue sauce and yogurt? That would have been disgusting. The vinegar probably would have curdled the yogurt.
These precious concoctions so that you can see just how fantastic they are. All right, so here's what I made.
Still smell the one
for Brandon. This was the milk-soaked Oreo cookie barbecue sauce and pesto. So if you are just listening to this podcast and are not able to see the visual, I'm sorry, you're missing out. I would recommend hopping over to YouTube so that you can see this, because it's worth it. And then here is the concoction. Oh, ew. I'm dripping it on myself. Here is the concoction that Brandon created for me. Coffee grounds, garlic, and lemonade. Disgusting. Disgusting. Okay, that was a unique experience. And I was definitely nicer to Brandon than he was to me.
Yes.
But as I mentioned, next time, I'll be back for ya. Okay, we've gotten that out of the way. It was an experience. Now let's chat some fun facts. I was very intrigued by this series of fun facts that I received. As I mentioned to you in previous episodes of the Brittany and Brandon show, I get daily facts emailed to me. No, you cannot pre-look. From interestingfacts.com. And I think there must be something in their algorithms based on if you open the email, then you get more than one in a day. So at this point, I'm getting 2, 3, 4 interesting facts a day. And they're just quick to read and they're interesting. And some of them I don't read because I'm not drawn to them, but some of them I really am, and this was one that just stuck out to me, so I'm sharing it with you. 5 famous events in history that never really happened. They even give you a read time, 6 minutes. I'm not going to read all of it. Most of us weren't in the room for history's most famous happenings. That means it just takes one slip-up or folktale, whether because of an overzealous biographer, a creative retelling, propaganda, or just a story that's easy to latch onto, to create a whole new version of events. From half-truths and misunderstandings to straight-up fabrications, here are 5 historical events that didn't happen like you probably thought they did. Number 1, George Washington didn't chop down a cherry tree. Number 2, Thomas Edison didn't invent the light bulb. It took a series of inventors to create a light bulb that was practical for everyday use, and although Edison was responsible for multiple links on that chain, he didn't do the work alone. Humphrey Davy in the early 1800s provided many of the earliest electric streetlights, while Scottish inventor James Bowman Lindsay was likely the first to demonstrate a sealed glass bulb that provided constant light through incandescent wires in 1835. Number 3, Marie Antoinette didn't say, "Let them eat cake." Number 4, William Tell didn't shoot an apple off his son's head.
What?
And number 5, Paul Revere didn't yell, "The British are coming." All right, and now we're going to breeze through the 10 facts of the Golden Girls that you may not know. The show was given a 13-episode order before there was a script. Wow. White was supposed to play Blanche, and McClanahan was originally Rose. Oh my gosh. Betty White was originally Blanche?
I know nothing about the Golden Girls.
Well, you are. That's sad. Blanche had 165 relationships. In a distant second was Dorothy, whose on-and-off-again relationship with Stan drove much of the storyline with a count of 43. Rose came in third with 30 men, even though she was the first to be seen in bed with a man on the show. Sophia's total count is 25, including her supposed secret first husband, Julio Iglesias. 5 of 10, none of the women were like their characters. So in real life, they weren't like their characters. Number 6, the cast once performed for the Queen Mother. So that's Queen Elizabeth II's mom. More than 100 cheesecakes were eaten during the show. I love that fact. I love cheesecake. There's another theme song verse about aging. The other verse says, "And when we both get older, with walking canes and hair of gray, have no fear, even though it's harder to hear, I will stand real close and say, thank you for being a friend." As appropriate as it was for the premise, that verse never made it into the show. 9 of 10, White was the oldest of the ensemble and lived the longest. Huh. I definitely did not know that.
She was like 100 years old when she died.
No. I didn't know she was the oldest out of the Golden Girls. And I didn't know...
Oh.
I knew she lived the longest, but I didn't know she was the oldest. And 10 of 10, each of the 4 stars won an Emmy Award. And that was so deserving. The Golden Girls is such a classic from my perspective. And I am entirely sad that you do not know about the Golden Girls.
No, I've never seen it.
You've never seen it? I think I'm having heartburn from the stuff you made me eat. My throat feels funny. Hopefully I'm not having some kind of allergic reaction to those 3 things mixed together.
You've had all 3 of them.
I've not eaten coffee grounds before.
It's coffee. You've had a sip of coffee. It's no worse than that.
Yes, it is. Okay, we're going to keep talking so that I don't have to think about the way my mouth tastes or the way my throat feels. Next up, we are going to talk about a funny marriage moment. This does have to do with our marriage because we were married at the time of the event, and the event never would have occurred if we were not... I mean, I guess it could have occurred if we weren't married, but it wouldn't have occurred if we were not in a relationship together. I guess maybe it still could have occurred. Anyway, it is related to our marriage, but not directly. There are a few other characters in the story. Let's put it that way. And now, with that confusing introduction...
Here's the story.
When Charlie was born, she immediately spent time in the NICU, and she was born at one hospital in Maine and was transported to a larger hospital in Maine hours after her birth, where they could treat her needs more effectively. So when she went to the second hospital, we knew we were going to be there for a good amount of time. Brandon and I were staying at a Ronald McDonald House that was close by to the hospital where Charlie was in the NICU. And we had many family members who came to visit us. Charlie's birth complication was not something that we saw coming. She didn't have any pre-existing conditions that we were aware of prior to her birth, so this was a surprise to all of us. And she was whisked, as I said, pretty quickly down to the NICU at this other hospital. So family members were not able to see her unless they traveled to us in this city where the larger hospital was. So Brandon's parents came, my parents came, my grandmother eventually flew up shortly after. She wasn't out of the NICU yet when my grandmother came. Or she had just gotten out of the NICU. My grandmother had a set...
Yeah, that's what it was. She had a set day to come. And Charlie was like 2 weeks early or something.
She was 2 weeks early to the day. So my grandmother had planned her flight and thought that she would be here just as Charlie was born or perhaps a few days before. And Charlie surprised us all. She was due in the very middle of April, so I was quite convinced I would have an April baby. And that is not what happened. Charlie came on the very last day of March, and when I was laboring with her, I just remember saying multiple times, I don't want her to have an April 1st birthday. And we were successful in that she did not have an April 1st birthday, but As you already know, the complications meant that we were quickly off to another hospital. So, many visitors came. The rule was visitors had to be with either Brandon or I to see her in the NICU, and both Brandon and I had IDs that had our picture and our name and a little more information, and we had to use that ID to get in to see her each time we went to the NICU. So guests had to be with one of us who had those IDs. So Brandon did not have really time off from work. He had a week that he was taking of his vacation time when Charlie was born, but he didn't have any kind of paternity leave, and the fact that she was in the NICU did not give him any additional time to be out of work. He could have taken more time, but it would have been unpaid, and that wasn't something that our young family that was still establishing itself could really handle. So, and we knew with her being in the NICU that we were going to have expenses from that experience, so it just wasn't the best option financially for him to stay in the area with us any longer. So, I mean, he did stay still at the Ronald McDonald House, but he would travel from the hospital area to his work and then back down in the evenings each day. And he did that for a little over a week until she was released and was home. But during this time, at one point, he was either at work or he was elsewhere, but he was not in the scene for this one. And so then you might be wondering, how is this a marriage story? Because if he is not even involved, he is in his own way. So Brandon's not around. Myself and Brandon's brother, Jared, were in Charlie's NICU room. The nurse came in. She called him Dad. And without skipping a beat, both he and I, not even making eye contact, we just rolled with it. We were like, you know what? It's fine. And so we joke to this day about how he could have taken her out of the NICU and nobody would have ever known because they all thought that he was her dad. And I guess it's maybe just because I'm married to Brandon and I spend a lot of time looking at Brandon, but in my personal opinion, Brandon and Jared don't look all that much alike. They definitely have similarities, which makes sense because they are biological siblings, but I really don't feel like they look that much alike. And I know that we were at the NICU and these people are not as familiar with us, but Charlie had been there for several days at this point, and this nurse was not interacting with us for the first time. She had seen the actual Brandon and myself on a handful of occasions, and so it's just funny to us that Jared was mistaken as Charlie's dad and that neither he or I chose to correct the nurse in the moment. We just kind of, I didn't have the energy.
I just wasn't there.
And Brandon just wasn't there, and we had a good laugh about it afterwards. It's still a story that we bring up and we joke about. And so that is our funny marriage story, that apparently Brandon and Jared are interchangeable in the eyes of many, because this is not the first time this has happened. There have been many other occasions when people who know both Brandon and Jared, because they know their whole family, will see Brandon somewhere and think that he was Jared and call him Jared and talk to him as though he's Jared, and the opposite, vice versa, will happen with Jared. And I think both boys just go with it at this point. From the stories that they've shared, they're just like, oh yeah, and, you know, they pretend that they are the other. It's like family friends that
or
they haven't
teachers.
Seen, or yeah, old teachers, because they both went to the same high school. And so many people seem to think that they look quite a bit alike, apparently, but I just don't see it. We are on to the master suite explanation. It is a potentially long story, but we will do our best to keep it short.
So, I don't even know. I'll just go along with it.
We're just explaining the whole, like, why we're building a master suite.
To have a room.
Well, yes, that's the simple explanation.
And have my own closet.
That's the simple explanation, but okay. So, the way that our house was built, it was a 5-bedroom house when it was originally built. Upstairs, there are 4 bedrooms, and the previous owners... So there have been 3 owners of this house. We are the third. The previous owners chose to turn 2 of the bedrooms into 1 really giant master bedroom. So there was some reconfigurations that happened with doorways and walls and such to make 1 giant bedroom on the end of on what was the end of the house. That is how we lived in the house. That's how it was when we bought it, and how we lived in this house for quite a while. And it was a great, nice big bedroom. There wasn't much wrong with it, but we had a third child, Colin, and we really wanted each of our kids to be able to have a bedroom of their own. We also wanted to have a master suite, because while we had a master bedroom, it was not a suite. There was no bathroom. And we did have our own closet simply because each of the bedrooms had a closet. And then when they turned it into one big bedroom, there were those two closets still. And they're a good size, but they're not walk-in closets. And so we knew that we wanted more space for ourselves as our family grew. And we also knew that we wanted a garage, which is not something our house had prior to us owning it.
The fifth bedroom is downstairs.
Yes, we do have one bedroom downstairs that we've never used as a bedroom. It was my craft room years and years ago before we had children. And then into a playroom after that. After I took my crafting items out of there, it became a playroom. And that is its current function as well. And so, it is technically a bedroom, but we don't even really think about it or factor it in. So anyway, we decided when the two upstairs bedrooms were turned into one, it became a four bedroom house, which was fine. Charlie was able to have her own room. Eli had his own room. We had our own room. And then Colin came along, and we knew that we were going to need to either expand the house or decide that the boys could share a room or something of that nature. Eli was in the original master suite of the home, or master bedroom of the home. Still not a suite. So his bedroom is the largest of the individual bedrooms. And we did feel like, you know, the boys could share, but they're 5 years apart. And so while it wouldn't be impossible, we knew we wanted to expand our home anyway. So we just decided our goal would be to have every child have their own space. And so when we built our garage, we also built an upstairs portion, and that is where our master suite is located, which is currently under construction. We chose to hire out for the entire exterior of the garage to be built, the foundation poured, and then the exterior built, all the windows put in, and doors and things like that. So we had the shell, which meant that the bottom portion of the garage was fully functional, because you just pretty much have a shell. And the upstairs portion was just four exterior walls with the windows, and we do have a set of sliding glass doors up there. And then Brandon has been working on finishing off the rest of it over the last several months. But when we knew that we were going to finally build the garage and begin our master suite, we decided to turn our one big long bedroom that took up the whole end of the house back into two separate rooms. And that way, one side would be Colin's bedroom, and the other side was going to end up serving as a pass-through. So it was an extension of the hallway that was already in our house, and if you just continue on, then you hit the new portion of our house, which right now has an exterior door on it, because that was what had to be placed there for fire codes when it was built, because we were not immediately finishing off the space. But when the space is finished off, we will remove that door and it will not be there. There'll be no door there. It will just be, you continue on down the hallway, you'll hit the laundry room and then our master suite. And if you want to see any more of the details around like what the floor plan is for our master suite, how we came up with the floor plan, all the steps that we've taken to turn it into the master suite that it is so far, then definitely check out our House to Home series, because all of that is discussed and shared there. But that other half, where the hallway is now, also has the rest of the bedroom portion, so there's still a little bit of it that is just like a nook now. So we have Lulu, our bearded dragon, in there, we have a desk in there, and there is a closet, which is currently Brandon's closet / the linen closet / Colin's closet. So it is a true multi-purpose space, but we are excited to have our master suite done for many reasons, one of which will be that Brandon will have his own walk-in closet for the first time ever. I will have my own walk-in closet, for the first time ever as an adult, and it will be the largest closet I've ever had. This will be Brandon's largest closet that he's ever had.
It's a sizable bedroom.
These closets are good size because we were able to do things exactly how we wanted them. We went through a ton of floor plans, all of which we designed on our own. I am very proud of the fact that we did all the floor plans, and we went through, I think it was six of them, and on the sixth one, that one is the one that we went with. And like I said, you can see all the floor plans in our House to Home series if you are interested. But I am very proud of the fact that we put the floor plans together, and we've designed the interior space 100%.
It still makes sense.
It does. I'm very proud of that too. It's like sometimes you think you have an idea, and then as you start to turn it into a reality, you're like, oh, that didn't really make sense. We should have done it, da 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 da. But I think we had enough time where we couldn't jump into working on the project because they were still finishing off elements of the garage that wouldn't allow us to get up there and start working yet. And we were able to just go through all those floor plans. And then we went upstairs and we laid some chalk lines down as makeshift walls. And that was very helpful because we were able to tell that there were a few things we were planning to do that weren't gonna make sense because angles were gonna be a little too sharp for turning as you walk down the hallway, or there's gonna be dead space that wasn't getting used well. And so we were able to make a couple of changes based on that as well. But when we get all of our stuff and cells moved over to our master suite, Colin will, he does have his own bedroom. We have decorated it as his room. We call it his room, but we are hanging out in there with him. We are bunking with Colin. And so in his room, between our queen size bed and his toddler bed and his dresser and our nightstands, and we have a piano in there and the dog crate in there. And you can probably imagine there's really not much space.
It's not a piano, it's a keyboard.
Yeah, it's a keyboard. There's pretty much a walking path around our bed, so you can get to my closet or you can get to the dog crate. And
my closet isn't even in the room.
Nope. His closet is outside in that little, we call it the bonus room now, where Lulu is. So that room will become entirely Colin's. All of my stuff will come out of that closet, and that will be Colin's closet. And then the closet in the bonus room will just become general storage, where we can house linens or potentially some of the kids' things, because we're thinking that's going to turn into like a little hangout space for them, like their own living room kind of, because our living room on the first floor is kid friendly, but we do prefer it to stay neat and tidy. So it would be nice if they just had kind of a zen zone where they could do whatever. They do have their bedrooms and they have a playroom. Do they really need another space? No.
No.
But they think they do. So.
And if they do use it, you're going to be upset that it's not neat and tidy. Because you can't close the door.
That's true. That is my thing about the playroom. Oh my gosh, I love that I can just pull that door shut. And the door is beautiful. And the little sign on it that says playroom is beautiful. I don't have to think about what's behind that door. The playroom is often a space where it looks like a bomb exploded. I've also done a video on my channel of organizing our playroom. That was actually my very first video that I ever put out. So check that out if you would like as well. And I did put many systems in place during that video that are still working well, but every space requires maintenance, a little bit of maintenance here and there. And that space just, it needs some love right now, but we are finishing up our school year. And so that is not at the top of my priority list. So, you know, we'll get there. In the summer, we do a little bit better.
If we didn't have kids, it would stay fine.
Yes, if we didn't have kids, the playroom would always be clean.
All the toys.
All the toys would be neat and organized if we didn't have kids. Yeah. But anyway, so in a nutshell, that is why we are building a master suite. That is how our home has transformed. Because we are building the master suite, we are very much looking forward to just having some space that is ours. We have been sharing a room with Colin for a
couple of years.
Well, okay, since he was born, technically, but we've been sharing the smaller room
for a year.
For Yeah, I think it's a little over a year now, and we were not planning on it being that long. When we decided to separate the two rooms and make Colin's room more defined and make the bonus room a bonus room, we thought that we would be there for maybe 6 months at the most. And life happened, and we should have known that that wasn't going to be the case, but I think I was really antsy to tackle that project because it was something that Brandon could do on his own without having to worry about the timeline of the workers who had been here dealing with the exterior of the garage, because this was inside of our home and they were not doing any work inside of our home other than the couple of days when they needed to take a window out of our existing home and make a doorway.
I mean, the annoying, we went without a heat register or a light in there forever, but the idea was that that new wall would be there and the heat register would go on it. That's why I did it.
Oh, right, right.
When
right.
I did it.
Yeah, because in our original, to us, when we bought this house master bedroom, the heat register ran all along
the outside wall.
And one section of that heat register had to be removed so a doorway could get put in there. And so our idea was build the wall to separate the two rooms so that the heat register could get, I remember this now, could get put back into that room, not where it was, but along the new wall.
Yeah.
And he had the wall built plenty in advance, but that was one of the things that we had to
nag the contractor.
Yes, about. Track our contractor down about many times. I know that no experience with any contractor is going to be perfect and run completely smoothly. I acknowledge that, and I don't have many ill things to say about our contractor or our experience with the company that we used, but there were a few things that for quite some time we were after the contractor to follow through with, and the heat register was one of them that I was getting pretty irritated about because the garage was done and they left our property and did not return in April one year. And then that fall, it was October, and we had asked all summer long trying to be prepared to have heat in that space prior to cold weather, and it was October before someone finally came out and redid our heat register and got that other section of heat register back in that room, which that was all part of the plan that we paid for up front, and our contractor had been paid his final installment, yet we did not have the heat register back. So luckily he held his word, did what he was supposed to do. We did have like a contract and everything that we had signed, so it was in writing. And eventually somebody did come and we did get the heat register back in there. And there have been a few things since then that we have contacted the contractor about, and he has taken care of everything. The wait time has been obnoxious. Right now we are still waiting on, I think, just one more thing. I mean, three things, but they're all screens. For two of the windows and the sliding door.
A lot of the stuff that was, I mean, I don't know if it's really an excuse now, but while everything was happening, it was like the issue with the garage doors that was in the thick of COVID, and garage doors apparently weren't being made anywhere.
They were like the hot commodity.
And like the screens were here initially, but then they were damaged in shipping or whatever. So, I mean, it's not...
But we have had replacement screens since the original screens, and they still did not fit.
Yeah.
So the next step is supposed to be that somebody who knows more about these windows is supposed to come out and try to put the screens in for us to see if the windows are possibly the issue, or if it is indeed the screens, and just problem solve a solution, because it's actually all of the light sources in our master bedroom, both windows and the sliding glass door, all three of them don't have functional screens. And I don't really want bugs in my bedroom. So we're gonna have to get that sorted out, because our plan is as soon as the mudding and taping and painting is done, we're going to move over there, even though the rest of it won't be done. And we'll sort of curtain off our bedroom, so when there's any work happening in the closets, my craft slash workout room, the bathroom, laundry room, when the rest of it's getting finished off, we will be able to keep the dust and stuff out. But that's going to leave us with no way to cool off when these hot summer nights come, because we don't have any screens. So we definitely need to get that solved quickly, would be ideal. But we digressed a little bit there, but that is the general gist of our master suite, why we built it, what it's looking like, the phase of things we're in now.
I think your battery's gonna die.
I think the battery is telling me it's gonna die, and we look like we're overheating. I don't know what this overheating is about. My camera has never done that before. So I don't know what that's about. So I guess we're going to wrap it up here. We're gonna skip the quote of the day because we're gonna die. And we're going to see you in the next episode of the Brittany and Brandon Show. So thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate you spending some time here enjoying our company and our stories and our humor at times. And if you know anybody that you feel like would really enjoy the Brittany and Brandon Show, please share it with them. We're just real people, husband and a wife, raising some kids, working full time, doing our best to balance it all, figuring things out as we go, and sharing it with you to at least bring you humor or possibly some helpful tips to make your life easier if you are on a similar path to ours or have younger children. Learn from us. Learn from some of our, I don't want to call them mistakes, but some of our experiences. So as I said, thank you very much for joining us. We cannot wait to see you.
Next time.
No. Oh. No, sir. We cannot wait to see you.
Well, hang on. You're going to tell me before you do this.
You need to remember. It's going to die. You have to
be quick. The next one.
In the next one.
In the next one.
We can't wait to see you.
In the next one.
Bye. Stressful soul.
You have garlic breath.
Oh, I wonder why. Ew. It's gross. Take care of that.
Ugh.
Take care of that junk.
Ugh. That's just...
Yeah, I ate that.